Hi everyone, in this video I'll be showing you how to reverse a number in C. So let's get started. So first we'll be getting the number n as an input from the user. So it's going to be printf, enter a number, and next we'll be having a variable n. This is going to be scanf percentage %d comma ampersand n. So we have got the number as an input. So this program is exactly similar to the sum of digits of a number, and the only difference is going to be in the step where we will be finding the sum. Alright, so for this we will be using a while loop, and we will be using a temporary variable to find the sum. So this program has like three steps. Okay, so the first step is going to be using a while loop, and that while loop condition is going to be our number n, which is the input, it should be greater than 0. So at the end of these steps, our number n will be 0. At that time, this while loop will fail and this while loop will break. So, and we'll be just printing the sum at the end. So this is the first step. The second condition is going to be, we'll be finding the sum. Okay, and this sum at the end will be equal to the reversed number. And how we will find this sum is that, we will be just extracting the last digit, okay? Extract the last digit, and we'll multiply that sum with 10, and we'll be just then again ascending to the sum itself. I will explain you when I'm coding this. And the final step is going to be, we will be removing the last digit. So here we are just extracting the last digit from the number, but the number still remains the same. But in the third step, we will be completely removing the remove last digit. So for example, you are having a number say 1, 2, 3. After this step, the number will become 12. What we will be doing is, we'll be just assigning the number equal to number slash 10. So by this way, we will be getting the quotient, and after getting the quotient, we'll be just assigning the same number to our number itself. So it's going to be 123/10. The quotient is 12. 120 is divisible, so the quotient will be 12, and the number we are then assigning to the number itself. So it will be 12 at the end. So 123 has become 12 if we divide it by 10. So this is how you remove the last digit. So now let's begin with the code. Let's just, you know, replicate these steps in C program. So first thing, it's going to be a while loop, and the condition is going to be number greater than 0, as I told you earlier, this one. And inside this while loop, we are having a variable sum, and we also need to extract the last digit. So we need two more variables, and the last digit, let the last digit variable be L, last digit, and we'll be having sum also, int sum equal to 0, and we are initializing the sum to be a 0, so to avoid getting a garbage value. Alright, so this is going to be something like this. First, we will be getting the last digit, extracting the last digit. It's going to be r equal to, not r, it's going to be l, this variable, l equal to our number modulus of 10. So this basically gives us the last digit of any number. So what modulus operator does is, it just gives us a remainder. So for example, 40 modulus of 10 will give us 0, because 40 is perfectly divisible by 10. So I'll go with 33. 33 modulus of 10 will give us 3, because 3 is the remainder. 30 is perfectly divisible, 3 is the remainder. And what if it's 34? We'll be getting the remainder as 4. So this basically gives us the last digit. So if it's, even if it's 134, we'll be getting still 4, because 130 is perfectly divisible. If it's 124, we'll be still getting 4, because 120 is perfectly divisible. So by this way, by doing modulus of 10 with a number, we'll be able to get the last digit, which is obviously the remainder. So this is how you will, you know, extract the last digit from a number. So we are good with this. Next one is going to be sum. So this is the critical part. It's going to be sum equal to sum asterisk 10, and it's going to be plus L. So this is the part where the reversing of the number happens. This is like magic. So I will literally explain you this step when I am reviewing this entire code with a demo number. I will just literally explain this, how it's going to work. And the next one is going to be the last step, which is removing the last digit. I have given you the code over here, n equal to n slash 10. So n equal to n slash 10. Basically, we are finding the quotient by dividing the number by 10 and just reassigning to that itself. So this basically removes the last digit. So I'm saving it, and at the end, we'll be printing our reverse number. So it's going to be reverse number equal to percentage %d, and the reverse number is actually present in this variable sum. Alright, you can name it reverse number or something, but I'll just keep it as sum. So this will have the reverse number. So let me first check if it's working fine, and later I'll be explaining you each and every line how this is going to work. So I'll just run this, enter a number. Let me go with 123. I need to get the output as 321. Here you can see I'm getting the output as 321, and let me run it again. Let me go with 5629. Hit enter. I need to get 9265. Here you can see I'm getting 9265. So now let me explain you how this is going to work. So let's assume that the input number n is going to be 123, and our desired reversed number is going to be 321. Okay, let's go with 123. So while loop is over here, our number n is 123 greater than 0, condition is absolutely true. It goes here, L equal to 123 modulus of 10. So what I told you, this basically extracts the last digit. It doesn't remove the last digit, it just, you know, extracts the last digit. So we'll be getting the last digit over here as 3, the last digit. It goes here, sum equal to sum. Our sum's initial value is 0. This is why I told you to initialize with 0, because if you don't initialize to 0 over here, you'll be getting a garbage value, or it may even throw an error. So it's good to initialize it to 0. Sum equal to, our sum's initial value is 0, so it's going to be 0 asterisk 10, because we're having here into 10, plus L. This is the last digit, which is going to be 3. So 0 asterisk 10 is 0 plus 3. Our sum is 3 during the initial iteration. And here we are just removing the last digit from our number itself. So n equal to number is 123 slash 10. This will give us the quotient as 12. And at the end, we are just assigning that number to our number itself. So at the end of the first iteration of while loop, our number n is going to be 12, because here we have just removed the last digit and we are just reassigning to the number itself. So it goes here, n greater than 0, 12 greater than 0, condition is true again. It goes here again, this time our number is 12. 12 modulus of 10 will give us the last digit as 2, because 10 is absolute divisible, 2 is the last digit, so it's going to be 2. And it goes here again, this time sum equal to, I'll just have here, so this is the second iteration, okay, sum equal to, this time our sum is not going to be 0, because we just had the sum as 3 in our previous iteration, so we need to use that value and we shouldn't use 0 over there. So it's going to be sum equal to 3 times 10, so it's going to be 3 multiplied by 10 plus L. Our L from the previous step is going to be 2, so it's going to be plus 2, so which is going to be 30 plus 2, that's going to give us 32. Alright, and we are getting closer to our reverse number. Our reverse number is 321. We are at 32. We just need to add one more here, which we'll be doing in the next step. It goes here, our number is 12 actually. 12 slash 10, the quotient is going to be 1. That's it. And now we have removed the last digit too. Our number is now just 1. It's not 12. 1 greater than 0, condition is true again. It's going to be L equal to n modulus of 10, which is 1 modulus of 10. And 1 modulus of 10 is not 0, it is actually 1. And next is sum equal to sum asterisk 10 plus L. So I'll just move here. This is going to be the third iteration, sum equal to, our sum value is 32 from the previous step, which is going to be 32 times 10 plus our L value from the previous step is 1. This is going to be plus 1. This is going to give us 320. 320 plus 1 is 321. And here we have got our reverse number. 321 is a reverse number. That's it. This is a reverse number. As I told you, the sum will be having our reverse number at the end. It goes here. Our number is actually 1. 1 slash 10 is not 1. This is 0. So at the end, our number becomes 0. It's not 1. It's not negative. It's literally 0. And we have got our reverse number, right? So at the moment, when our number becomes 0, we would have already got our reverse number stored in the variable sum. So it goes here, number is 0, 0 greater than 0, the condition is false, while loop breaks, and we will be getting the sum printed, which is the reverse number printed in the output. So this is basically how this works. I hope this step is clear to you. This is how this is going to work. So I'll just go with the number 65008. Here you can see I'm getting 80056. So this is the program, guys. I hope you have found this video useful. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of videos in C, C++, Java, Python, Node.js, React.js, MongoDB, MySQL, Spring Boot, and other CRUD operations. Check the playlist. Subscribe me. Thanks for watching.